Every cookie is all handcrafted, handmade from scratch. Mine is like crispy on the outside and actually soft in the inside. My name is Regine and I'm the founder of Nasty Cookie. Nasty Cookie is a bold concept. It's just cookie but it's an amplified, outrageous version of it. For now, we have 9 flavours. So there's a classic chocolate chip, the dark chocolate chip, the half and half, biscoff cookie, cookies and cream, choco bueno, old smarties, pretzel and Reese's cup. Out of the 9, my personal favourite would be the biscoff cookie. I like anything that's caramel, so biscoff is caramelised cookie. A cookie on top of a cookie. There are some customers who actually buy like 2 boxes just of biscoff cookie. So I can say that that must be my best seller. And it also comes with fillings, so you can inject marshmallow, Nutella or dolce de leche. I actually started Nasty Cookie because I wanted to raise funds for myself to actually travel to Australia on a working holiday visa. I thought online would be a good platform because there's no leasing, there's no commitment, hence the name Nasty Cookie. Like, I did not really put any thought to it. So it's a kind of like an accidental success that really blew so big that now even when I want to go to Australia, I'm kind of stuck in Singapore because of the business. But it's also a happy problem, I would say. I was very overwhelmed, especially for the first online order, as I have 256 cookies to bake. I have never done a mass baking kind of setting, and I know that every single tray goes in only can fit 9 cookies. I actually spent like almost 15 hours just to make that. I told myself, oh my god, I regretted this decision of creating this. I called my brother in, who has never ever baked before, but now he's even more strict with the dough. I call him the Gordon Ramsay of nasi cookie because he's in a way the dough expert, that he always can touch the dough and like good dough. Or like bad dough, he'll just like throw. I have been a personal trainer since I was 18. Because I stepped into the fitness industry, I got a bit health conscious. So I actually hardly eat out, but I have random cravings. But I do not want to like ruin my diet because I'm actually tracking my calories, my protein, my carbohydrates and fats. So what I did was to learn online and I created my own recipes. Since the first time I made it, it's the same recipe throughout. It's really an accidental success for this recipe. One gym user actually came up to me, asked me, oh, I see you already in the gym, actually what do you work? I just said, I bake cookies for a living. So people, it's like, if I'm in the gym, you're supposed to like eat chicken breast, steam with like broccoli and stuff. But for me, actually I have an all-rounded food lifestyle. Creating nasi cookie is also to tell people that even though I'm in the fitness industry, I still can remain fit and healthy, but I still eat all these sinful treats, not every day, but I still eat them and can incorporate them into my diet. In the retail, we actually only have 2 small ovens because I realized that big batches, you cannot get the same texture. So it's actually very laborious. So I use quality ingredients. Like for my chocolate chips, I'm using chocolate couvertures and not chocolate chip. Couverture chocolates are made from pure cocoa butter, where chocolate chips is made from vegetable oils, which most people use because it's a cheaper ingredient. But for me, I really emphasize a lot on the quality. And from there, I get a lot of feedbacks and good reviews that actually encourage me to take a bigger step and start a retail. For Funan, it was really a spontaneous move. I did everything from scratch, from the design of the entire store to the packaging, to the branding, to the marketing. In the past, I think that business, oh, it's easy. It's a glamorous thing to be a businessman. Actually, business is a huge responsibility. You really need to make a lot of sacrifices in terms of like your own lifestyle. And also, it's no longer me, myself and I. Whatever I do, whatever I say, affects everyone around me and even my customers. Now to see them in real life and for people to buy one cookie and I see them re-queuing back to buy one entire box, it makes me feel like I did something right.